Good morning, students. So today we will continue with the lesson business services, and the topic which I am going to discuss is insurance. Now let us understand what is insurance. So when we say insurance is a contract between two parties, and these two parties are insured and insurer. Now let us understand कि इंश्योर्ड कौन है और इंश्योरर कौन है. सो द पार्टी विच प्रोमिसज टू इंडेमनीफाई द लॉस इज कॉल्ड इंश्योरर, दैट इज इंश्योरेंस कंपनी. ओके, द पर्सन और द प्रॉपर्टी विच इज सब्जेक्ट टू रिस्क इज कॉल्ड इंश्योर्ड, दैट इज क्लाइंट. ओके, सो and the agreement between insured and the insurer will be termed as insurance policy. So just keep in your mind that it is a contract between insured and the insurer. Okay, as you can see, insured is the client and insurer is the insurance company, and the contract become the insurance policy. Now talking about the functions of insurance. Now what are the functions of insurance? Let's see the first one, that is providing certainty. Now we all know that is business have to pass through many uncertainty. Okay, that is ups and down situation in the business. So for that purpose, the insurer charge, that is it provides certainty of payment for the risk of loss. So insurance when the company take the insurance, it gets a certainty for the risk of loss, and for this getting the benefit of risk, the insurer charges premium for providing the certainty. Okay, so the first function is providing certainty. Second is protection. Now insurance cannot stop the happening of the risk, yes, but it can definitely give the protection. Okay, so events like natural calamities, many times earthquake, flood, and sometime theft also take place. Okay, that is not a part of natural calamities, but you can say that is theft or some fire being occurred due to carelessness. So against all these factors also insurance company provide protection. Then the third point is risk sharing. So here when the business person or the company take the insurance, so insurance is like an arrangement in which a large number of people who are exposed to the same risk contribute to the fund maintained by the insurance company. The fourth point is assist in capital formation. Now whatever fund is collected by the insurance company, that is in the form of premium, is invested in various income generating schemes. So ultimately it leads to the formation in the economy. Okay, so these are the functions being related to insurance. Principle of insurance. Now the contract of insurance is based on the following principles. The first one is utmost good faith. So when the insured and the insurer, that is when they sign the contract, okay, so it's like they should have faith in each other. Iske liye they have to disclose all the information. Okay, so when the company is taking insurance policy, they have to put faith in each other, and whatever information is there, they have to disclose it fairly. Then the next one is insurable interest. When we say insurable interest, that is the insured must have an insurable interest in the subject matter of insurance. Okay, so this is the next one, that is insurable interest. Insurable interest in the property if he will be adversely affected by its destruction. Okay, that's why he take the insurance. Then secondly, the insured must either own a part or a whole of the subject matter of insurance, or he must be in such a position that injury to it would affect him adversely. Okay, agar mujhe usme koi like insurable interest nahi hai, so definitely main insurance nahi lungi, isn't it? So when the company take any insurance, so company is having some insurable interest in it. So in case of insurance property, insurable interest of the insured must exist at the time of entering into the contract. Okay, insurable interest hai, isliye policy ko liya hai. Then the third point is related to indemnity. Okay, when we say the principle of indemnity, the term indemnity means security against loss. So the purpose of this principle is to put the insured in the event of loss and in the same position that he occupied immediately before happening of the event. Okay, now you can take the example here. जैसे कि इफ़ अ पर्सन हैज़ इंश्योर्ड हिज हाउस अगेंस्ट फायर, ठीक है, तो उसने इंश्योरेंस लिया है और द अमाउंट है 1,50,000 एंड ही सफ़र्स अ लॉस ऑफ 1,00,000. अब उसको जो लॉस हुआ है वो 1,00,000 का हुआ है. सो द इंश्योरर विल पे हिम 1,00,000 and not the policy amount of 1,50,000. Okay, so it's like principle of indemnity is not applicable to life insurance, as loss arising on that of the assured cannot be measured in terms of money. Okay, तो ये जो principle है ये applicable है goods के लिए, it is not applicable to life insurance. ओके, जैसे किसी की डेथ हो गई एक्सीडेंट में, तो हम ऐसे नहीं बोलते हैं कि उसका कितना पार्ट डैमेज हुआ था उस हिसाब से इंश्योरेंस होगा. बट दिस इज़ एप्लीकेबल फॉर गुड्स, एज आई टोल्ड यू, अगर द लॉस इज़ अप टू 1,00,000, देन दैट पार्टी विल बी पेड द लॉस ऑफ 1,00,000. सो दिस प्रिंसिपल इज़ एप्लीकेबल फॉर गुड्स, नॉट फॉर लाइफ इंश्योरेंस. देन मूविंग ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट वन, that is proximate cause. So in proximate cause, causes of loss may be of two kinds, that is insured perils and uninsured perils. Okay, according to this principle, the insurer is liable for the loss only when such loss is proximately caused by the perils which are stated in the policy. Okay, now we can understand this with the help of a example. Now in the example, Rohit took a marine policy to protect his goods from perils of sea, and on the way the goods were spoiled by the rats. Okay, अभी उसने किसके लिए protection लिया है, for the waterways, isn't it? So against the perils of sea. लेकिन what happened, the goods were destroyed or spoiled by rats on the way. In such case, no compensation will be given as loss caused due to rats in the remote causes and not the proximate cause. So we can't consider it as a proximate cause. However, if the rats make the hole in the ship and water enter from the holes and spoil the goods, then the Rohit is entitled for the compensation. So this is how we can understand it. Okay, that is proximate cause. The next one is subrogation. When we talk about subrogation, here also I will take one example. Like if an insured car has been stolen, then the insurer will compensate the loss as the car was covered by insurance. However, if the car is recovered later, then the insurer will have all the right on the car. This is because the insured should not be allowed to make any profit by selling the lost car being recovered. Okay, because already insurance company ne compensate kar diya hai. So even after, like if insurance company ko wo car wapas mil rahi hai, recover ho rahi hai, to uske upar right insurance company ka hoga, na ki jo car ka owner tha, because the company has already reimbursed the loss to the insurance company. This is like call as principle of subrogation. Ye when fire also occurred, usme jitna bhi damage goods ke baad agar jo scrap hota hai, that is also in the hand of insurance company, because insurance company has already reimbursed the loss. So this is what we say the principle of subrogation. It must be noted that principle of subrogation applies to all the insurance contract which are contracts of indemnity. Now next one is contribution. When we talk about contribution, according to this principle, insurer who has paid the claim amount under an insurance policy has a right to recover the proportionate contribution from the other insurer. The insured can take more than one policy on the same property. So this is what you have to keep in mind. Then the last one is mitigation. So in mitigation, it is a duty of the insured to take reasonable step to minimize the loss or damage to the insured property. Okay, abhi isme hum ek example lete, like if the goods kept in the warehouse are covered by fire policy and the warehouse catches fire, theek hai, us warehouse go down jisko kehte hai uski fire policy hai aur achanak fire has occurred there, then the insured must try to recover the goods and save them from fire to minimize the loss. Aisa nahi sochna hai ki bhai humne insurance karwaya to goods ko jalne do, theek hai. Jo insured hai, he must try to the level best to save the goods and to minimize the loss or damage. Okay, so these are all the principle of insurance which we have done today. And moving on to the next topic, that is the type of life insurance policies. Okay, so when we talk about the types of life insurance policy, before that types of insurance, we have life insurance and general insurance. So when we say life insurance, the list is been before you, and in general insurance marine insurance, okay, and fire insurance, these insurance has been covered in this general insurance, fire insurance, marine insurance. Okay, now moving on to the different types of life insurance policy. The first one, whole life insurance policy. Then the next one, joint life policy. Then children endowment policy, endowment life assurance policy, annuity policy. So these are all life insurance policy. Jo fire insurance hai, marine insurance hai, health insurance hai, these are all general insurance policy. So health insurance nowadays during the pandemic, all the peoples are becoming more cautious about their health, and you know that even for corona, number of insurance policies are also being issued. Now, fire insurance is like taken to cover the risk against the fire. Marine insurance is being taken by the companies in order to cover the risk against the waterways. Now, type of marine insurance policy, that is hull insurance, freight insurance and cargo insurance. So this is that's all for the syllables in business services. The postal services is being deleted for looking to the situation of pandemic. So that's all. We have completed the topic here, that is business service chapter is completed here. And when we will start the next lecture, that will be on the new lesson. Thank you.